My name is Wilson Wong, and I'm Head of Insight and Futures at the Chartered Institute of Personnel and Development in the UK. I think the maritime industry is facing rough waters ahead, given the reaction to globalization. The industry has grown for many decades on the back of globalization, and then now you have a situation where there are countries who are challenging the rules of global trade. They are inflicting tariffs on each other. There are more and more disputes going through that will impact the flow of trade across the world, and this will impact the maritime industry tremendously. This is just one of the externalities that leadership in this industry will have to deal with. There are so many other things that they need to pay attention to: the changing expectations of their workforce, the changes in terms of politics and ideology towards more localism, the issues about environmental and sustainability, whether global trade is a good thing or a bad thing. So there are huge conundrum that they have to navigate in order to get their industry, you know, shipshape. Well, I hope that the conversations between the panelists and those from industry will be a rich one, where they can talk about, you know, policy changes. They can talk about how certain drives like the sustainability will then be enacted in a way that makes sense for both industry, their workers, and the people who depend on the maritime sector for their business. So there's been a lot of talk about climate change. There's been a lot of talk about regulations. There's been a lot of talk about financing in this sector. But there's been less consensus about how this is going to be enacted, planned, and rolled out. I think these kinds of fora are useful because you're bringing together leaders across the sector to talk about some of these commonalities and to begin to perhaps build some understanding of where things might change for the better. I think the first way that you can bring these groups together: academia for the evidence that they have, industry for the fact that they are responsible for, you know, thousands of working lives, and government in terms of protecting societal expectations and needs. When you have a consensus of what the outcomes should be, that gives you a platform on which to bring the three parties together in order to begin that journey of improving regulations or changing financing structures or looking at different ways of doing what you already do from the evidence provided in academia. I think what I wanted to communicate really was that we live in an increasingly interconnected, complex world where not one actor can change enough to make a difference. And this interconnected world means that you have to be constantly monitoring the externalities. What's going out? What's going on elsewhere? And understand that what is happening in China is going to impact somebody in South Africa, who's going to impact another person in Santiago, who's then going to impact somebody in Japan. So this kind of worldview needs also to be tied in with an idea of time, that we cannot continue to make decisions for the short term. We need to know that what we do today has an impact for many generations to come. So what I see as an advantage of these kind of conferences is to bring together leaders from different parts of the different stakeholders, but also then to challenge each other as to the quality of their decision making and whether or not they're making the best choices for the generations to come.